Welcome. In this video, we'll see the conditional branching instructions present in 8051. So first instruction is CJNE A, 20 hex, next. So the meaning of this instruction is that the value present in accumulator will be compared with the value present in 20 hex location. And if both the values are not equal, then the program counter will jump to the label next. Whereas if the values present in accumulator and 20 hex location, if those are same, then it will not jump to the label next, whereas it will execute the next instruction. So let me execute this instruction. So now the value present in accumulator was 0 and the value present at 20 hex location was also 0. So that's why it has not jumped to the label next. So instead of that, it has now come to the next instruction and it will execute the next instruction. So I've just written a random instruction over here. So this instruction is of direct addressing mode because a direct address is mentioned in the instruction. This instruction is of 3 bytes. 1 byte is required for storing opcode. 1 byte is required for storing the direct address and 1 byte is required for storing this address of the program memory where the jump is to be done. Next instruction is CJNE A, 30 hex, next one. Now in this instruction, the value present in accumulator will be compared with the value 30 hex. So since here hash symbol is there, this is the immediate value and the value present in accumulator will be directly compared with this 30 hex value. And if both the values are not equal, then the program counter will jump to the label next one. Now the value present in accumulator is 0. So this will be compared with the value 30 hex. Now obviously 0 is less than 30 hex and both are not equal. So it will jump to the label next one. Now one more thing to remember about CJNE instruction is that if the value present in accumulator is smaller than the value present in the second operand, then the carry flag will be set. So as we can see here, the carry flag is right now 0. So if I execute this instruction, the carry flag will become 1. So it has become 1 because the value present in accumulator was less than this value 30x. So this instruction is of immediate addressing mode and this instruction requires 3 bytes for its representation. 1 byte is required for opcode, 1 byte is required for storing this immediate data, 8-bit data, and 1 byte is required for storing the jump address in the form of this label. So next instruction is CJNE R4, 40 hex, next 2. So this instruction is again used to compare the value present in R4 register with this immediate 8-bit value, that is hash 40 hex. So if both the values are not equal, then the program counter will jump to the label next 2. And again similarly, if the value present in R4 register is less than 40 hex, then carry flag will be set, whereas if the value present in R4 register is greater than 40 hex, then carry flag will be 0. So let us put some value in R4 register. So let me put here value as 50 hex. So now this 50 hex value is greater than 40. And right now the carry flag is 1. So when I execute this instruction, the program counter will jump to the label next 2. Because the value present in R4 is not equal to this immediate value. And at the same time, the value present in R4 is greater than the value present over here, that is 40 hex. So carry flag will be 0. So if I execute that, you can see that the carry flag has become 0. So this instruction is again of immediate addressing mode and it is having 3 bytes for its representation. 1 byte is required for opcode, 1 byte is required for the 8-bit immediate data, and 1 byte is required for storing the address, that is address of the program memory in the form of this label. So now we can see that the program counter has jumped to the next two label because the values here were not equal. So the final instruction is CJNE @R0 comma hash 10 hex comma next. So the meaning of this instruction is that here R0 will act as a pointer, and R0 is going to point to some RAM memory location. So the value present at that RAM memory location will be compared with this immediate 8-bit value, that is 10 hex. And if both the values are not equal, then program counter will jump to the label next. Whereas if the values are equal, then it will simply execute the next instruction. It will not jump to the label next. So now R0 will be pointing to the 20 hex RAM memory location. So there the value is 00 and the immediate value is 10 hex. So these two values will be compared. Now the value present at 20 hex is smaller as compared to 10 hex value. So the carry flag will be set. Right now the carry flag is 0. And at the same time, the program counter will jump to the label next, since both the values are not equal. So let me execute this instruction. So you can see that the carry flag has become 1 and the program counter has jumped to the label next. So this arrow, yellow arrow, is over here, that is next. So it has jumped to this location. So this instruction is of indirect addressing mode. It is having a register as a pointer, and this instruction requires 3 bytes for its representation. 1 byte is required for opcode, 1 byte is required for storing the 8-bit immediate data, and 1 byte is required for storing the address of the program memory where the jump is to be done. So this is about some of the branching instructions present in 8051. In next video, we'll see some more branching instructions present in 8051. For more information, you can log on to the website given in the description of this video. Thank you.